Welcome to the first virtual neurology clerkship at New York Medical College. I would like to start with by just saying how extraordinary these times are, and I never thought that I would be doing this with you virtually, but here we go. I would like to begin with some mottos. So the New York Medical College motto is building on excellence of our past, which I think is appropriate here. And I think it's also appropriate to look at the motto, which is on my medical school alma mater seal, which is NYU School of Medicine. And on the seal, it says, Perstare e prestare, to persevere and to excel. So I think we're fulfilling at least the perseverance portion here, and I hope that we can excel. So I would like to give you an update on what we're planning for this virtual clerkship for the next 4 weeks. Conferences will have to be by Zoom. I will send you the Zoom link. I anticipate doing a 1 p.m. conference with you every week out of the 4 weeks. And during that conference, we'll take a look at something that's called Nervesim.com, N-E-R-V-E-S-I-M.com. They actually have virtual patient cases where there are two versions of this. One has pre-specified things that you can click on and ask the patient, and that is called the selection version of it. And there's another one which is a free text. I think the free text is too difficult for us to use at this point, so we'll use the selection. And there's a virtual patient where he will or she will respond to your questions, and you need to discover some things on the exam. And there's a progress bar where it shows you how much of the proficiency that you actually obtain. And then there's also a physical exam portion, for at least for cranial nerves and a couple of other selected findings, where the virtual patient will actually do what you click on and what you tell them to do. And so, for example, you can do a cranial nerve exam with an extraocular motion exam. You can actually click, there's actually a hand button, and you click on to tell the patient to follow your finger, and he will actually look at your finger, and you can gauge what the eye movements are. So I think that this is the best that we can do given the limited circumstances that we have. So I'm going to assign 4 cases. It will be in your email. The first case will be Bill Jackson, and I will show you the screenshots in a moment. I would like you to get through and get me a screenshot of all of the history components being completely full. Yes, for proficiency and for suggested to use as a pass-fail threshold. On the website, they say you don't need to meet 100%, but because this is not timed, kind of open book, I would just like you to take a screenshot that you fulfilled everything in the history and physical exam sections. And then at the end of these Nervesim cases, there's actually a place when you click on that you're finished, there's a place to do a quick progress note. So we are using the test drive version of Nervesim because I think it would be too clumsy to try to set up accounts right now with everything that's going on. So just screenshot from the test drive, and I'll give you the link shortly. What I'm planning to do is to just give you comments on these screenshots. You can email them to my Gmail address, and the format of those is very similar to what you would have if you were on the step 2 clinical skills. There's also a post-encounter note, so that's why I want you guys to get used to this system. It's just that when you submit, because this is a test drive, we don't have a copy of it. Now, I want this to be done before Wednesday 1 p.m. on each of the weeks, so that at 1 p.m. we can have a Zoom session. We'll talk about what worked and what didn't work with your patient, and if you've had any difficulties. And then I would like to talk as a group about the actual differential diagnosis and findings, and you know, how to put this together. I will actually share with you some of the examples. So technically speaking, the first case is a little bit open book because I'm actually going to show you some of the answers at the end of my video, but I think we have to have you learn how do you interact with this. All right, so what I also want to do is for you guys to use information from this history and physical. Even though you're giving me a screenshot of the progress note at the end, I actually will count doing all four of these cases and sending me four HMPs from the information that you gather as the formal case report / HMP for dissertation. So once again, each week you're emailing to my Gmail a comprehensive HMP, which lists the information that you're able to gather from this patient. That's in addition to the snapshot of the progress note at the end. I will give you individualized comments. You need to give me all four of these HMPs for the case report to count as a yes. All right, next, the Huntington's disease assignment will be emailed out, and it talks about a patient and what are the risks of developing Huntington's disease and also possible other diseases that are similar to Huntington's. So just please send me emailed responses to that assignment once we send it out to you. I'm working with the Clinical Skills Center to work on some type of virtual and safe standardized patient eval. So this might be something where you would be assigned times to call in to do a virtual encounter, such as a telephone encounter, or if it's possible to do this as a FaceTime or video encounter, we would do that too. I am still working on the details with the Clinical Skills Center. We will update you as soon as we can. Pet log. So there's the McGraw-Hill online case files in neurology. I was told by other students that I think we have enough in there to count for each of the 12 diagnoses. Of course, they cannot be active, but we can fulfill at least 12 as observed. So you need to track them in the pet log and still at the end of the rotation print out or give us, well, PDF, virtual printout, and email the PDF to the Neuro Clerkship official email. Now, we also have what's called the weekly themes. These are video lectures that are already listed in LCMS Plus, and these are for self-study. There's a variety of topics, and we are making sure that the quizzes are open. The quizzes will be and can be used for self-study. Obviously, there's no presentation checklist, but I may ask some of you on Zoom to present portions of the Nervesim cases to the group as if this had been Brown's presentation. So as far as feedback goes, I will try to give you feedback on your written work in my emailed responses to your HMPs. We can also give some feedback during the Zoom sessions as well, and you know, even as a group, whether we agree or disagree with a certain differential diagnosis. There's not enough info to count for mid-clerkship feedback. I believe that for the verbal comments at the end for the assessment, well, of course, you are turning in work. I will provide feedback based on, you know, the level of interactivity on our sort of virtual rounds discussions and the depth and quality of the, you know, case reports that you turn in. And I believe the NBME will still count. The medical school is working, first of all, on when the NBME shelf exam will be administered, and then if there are any grading cutoff changes to that or not. That is still under active discussion, and you'll learn about that from the medical school itself. Let me just make sure. Okay, so with that, let me just kind of turn this around, and we'll show you the screens with my virtual patient. All right, so this is the virtual patient here, and I just wanted to show you, so this is Bill Jackson. So you have this main window with the patient over here. On the right side, you click in and there's some questions that you can ask the virtual patient. So if you look over here, I ask about double vision. Does it change with distance? Do you have sensitivity to light? He's saying that it doesn't. He will actually speak to you, although these are just snapshots. But as you see over here, there's an interview progress bar. So you note that I got my points for grading, and then I had my points for history of present illness. And again, the Bill Jackson case, I guess this will be a little bit open book. You see that there was a discovery, that the patient was greeted warmly, associated symptoms are elicited, and I get points for each of these associated HPI findings. Now over here, when I was further in the case, I asked them more questions, and again, this is kind of open book, but you see that I already got points for performing a fundoscopic exam, pupillary response exam, extraocular movements, and then empathy and concern. I got points for making supportive statements as well. And then over here, just to kind of show you, I was telling him to look in certain directions, to follow my finger, and then I was asking, this is a virtual patient, you can ask them, sharp or dull. So let me kind of go over here. You also see here, this was at a different point here where I was looking for, is there a family history of any disease, and things of that nature. And then over here, this is a post-encounter note. So we'll talk about this. I thought that this was, well, I'll let you know. I thought that this was an isolated sixth nerve palsy from diabetes, but I would love to have a robust discussion about this case, and you can let me know if you agree or disagree. So for Nervesim, I'm just showing you, I'm going to nervesim.com. And then, the whole logging in, it's a little clumsy there. So we're just gonna go to the test drive section. I'm gonna go next. I'm gonna do a system check. I'm gonna go to exam room. So here, these are the cases that I would like to work on. So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4. Week 1, Bill Jackson. Week 2, Kathy Jackson. Week 3, Kathy Jacobs. Week 4, Jennifer Moore. And then over here, you got the chief complaint, right? Don't forget that for your HMPs. And then the chat is in beta. So I just want you to use selection. So we're just gonna scroll down. Ready to begin. Okay, so there's a loading screen. Takes a while to load, and then, of course, if somebody's having trouble, you can let me know. So this is your patient. So you can start by going into the interview button, and you greet them.
Hi, doctor.
All right, so I made my greeting. This goes into the discovery section, that the greeting was done. And then over here, I got points for the greeting. So we can talk about the chief complaint, right? So we can say, what brings you
into? I've been having double vision and headaches.
Okay. And then we go to the HPI, and you know, I'm not gonna go through the whole thing, but you know, I'll let you do that on your own. So I'm going to go into the physical exam. So eyes.
Yes, ever since I woke up a couple days ago.
Okay, so this is cool. So if you do, follow my finger. You go over here, see how it's on follow finger, and you grab the hand and you move the finger. Now, for the software to count this, I think you kind of have to go like with the hand all the way, perhaps into like all the corners. So you got to make that complete sort of H. And you saw how here on the physical exam, you know, it says check the extraocular movements. Now you can also check convergence, which is pretty cool. You can go front and back. You have some other things that you can do here. You can switch over to visual fields. You can have him cover the eye. And then I'll tell him to read the lowest line.
PHUNTDZ.
Okay, he uncovered, and this is cool. So you click over here and you press on the light. You see the pupils? So you can do a pupillary exam. And here, you can do a fundoscopic, right? So it's clear fundi. So you can go over here. Do a fundoscopic on the other side, and then when I did that, so we're gonna exit, you see that I got points for performing a fundoscopic, pupillary response, and extraocular motions. So I got all three of the targets here, right? So we're gonna probably just get out of that. All right, and then, you know, if you were to be finished, right, you go to finished, you go to patient encounter note, and they changed it. So I guess you can do it by email. Again, I don't know if there's some bugs in it or whatnot. You know, obviously this is Bill Jackson. So I would still like you to screenshot this. I mean, if you've got the email, of course, receiving the email is cleaner. But if not, take the screenshot. But also, I would like a screenshot of the exam room with these proficiencies here being all done. You know, these discoveries are going to move over up because they show you only like 5 or something like that. And then here, this is showing you a chat, just like a Facebook chat. So I think this is pretty cool. So again, with the patient, we'll do this.
I'm trying not to.
All right, so patient's trying not to worry. We've got an empathy and concern button here, and you know, he feels comforted about his worries. So just to show you. So again, thank you so much for listening in. I'm looking forward to our virtual Zoom encounter. And until then, you can test out this technology. Thank you again.